Well, 100 years ago this coming Sunday, the Titanic hit an iceberg and sank in the Atlantic Ocean. Some 1,500 people died, but about 700 did survive.
And one of those survival stories lives on in Harford County.
Her name, of course, the Titanic.
There is a piece of Titanic history tucked away in Aberdeen, Maryland. A journal, the firsthand account of Titanic survivor Elmer Zebley Taylor.
Here the orchestra was playing and many people were sitting at tables playing cards as they passed through. There was...
Now in the hands of his great cousin, Jim Carroll.
And at that time, this was the latest and greatest in early 20th century technology. And he was able to interpret it all and absorb it all and appreciate it for what it was.
That's because Mr. Taylor was an inventor, an engineer, a first-class passenger along with wife Juliet and business partner Fletcher Lambert-Williams.
I think he estimated that the ship was going something like 22.75 knots. I mean, just based on the rotations of the propellers that he could hear.
On the night of the 15th, Taylor writes, an impact woke him up. He went on deck.
I said to a sailor, why have we stopped? Struck an iceberg, he said. I walked forward, saw nothing peculiar but crushed ice under my feet, which had been shivered from the iceberg. Picking up a piece of ice about the size of an egg, I went below, stopped at my cabin and told my wife we'd struck an iceberg and then went along to William's cabin. He was sitting up in bed in a dressing gown, reading a book, smoking a huge cigar and sipping a highball, which was beside him. Well, Williams, I said, we've struck an iceberg and I've brought you a piece of it to put in your highball, so here goes.
Clearly unfazed and convinced the Titanic was unsinkable, Taylor and his wife only got into a lifeboat when ordered to. And then, a half mile out, it hit him.
All lights were extinguished, synchronizing with the crash. Darkness prevailed. The idealized conception of mortal man gradually settled bow first under the icy waters in mid-Atlantic, said to be the deepest part of the ocean. A real tragedy. 1,500 or more people were plunged into the ocean, all calling for help, a sound never to be forgotten.
And Jim Carroll says Elmer Zebley Taylor lived with that day for the rest of his life.
It was said that he just never recovered from this, the horror of what he had experienced.
Now, here's something interesting. So he was an engineer. He couldn't see what happened when it sank. It was too dark.
Right.
But he surmised by what he heard and what he calculated that the ship went up and was too heavy to support its own weight,
right,
and that it split in half. Of course, nobody believed that theory until Ballard found the boat all those decades
later.
And he was right.
Still a compelling story.
Yeah.
Compelling.